都平安，来到了今年的我们的这个感恩节的这个时间。
Thank God for His grace that we may peacefully come here to this time of Thanksgiving.
在圣经里面告诉我们，我们要凡事都要感恩。
In the Bible, it tells us that we must give thanks in all circumstances.
所以我们今天这段的时间是可以让我们来回想，我们在这一年当中，可能我们遇到的疾病。
So today, this time is a good time to reflect upon what has happened. Perhaps we encountered an illness.
或者是碰到了一些困难的事情。
Perhaps we encountered difficult situations.
或者是在工作上不顺利。
Perhaps we did not have a smooth time in our careers.
或者是神在今年当中大大给我们祝福，凡事都顺利。
Or perhaps God has greatly blessed us this past year and everything has been very smooth.
不管在任何的状况之下，圣经的教导是我们要凡事感恩。
No matter in what circumstance, the Bible tells us that we must give thanks in all circumstances.
所以在今天的感恩节的特别机会当中，我是想说要邀请我们的信徒自动的你想要见证的，想要讲对从神来领受的恩典的话，那请你就预备心，就准备来到前面来，我再给安排给你们来这里来讲你的见证。
So today in this Thanksgiving special service, I ask everyone if you are willing to please come and share about the grace of God.
所以要在见证之前呢，我想跟大家一起来读一段圣经。
And before we testify, I would first like to share a passage in the Bible with everyone.
我们来看诗篇的103篇。
Let's turn to Psalm 103.
我们从第一节看到第五节。
Let's look from verse 1 to 5.
诗篇一百零三篇，从第一节到第五节。
Psalm 103 verses 1 through 5.
我们大家出声的来念，用英文也可以，用中文的也可以。我们从第一节念到第五节。
And everyone, please read aloud in your own language.
好，第一节。
Verse 1.
我的心啊，你们要称颂主，凡在我里面的，要称颂他的圣名。第二节，我的心啊，你要称颂主。不可忘记他一切的恩惠。第三节，他赦免你们的一切罪孽，医治你们一切的疾病。第四节，他救赎你的命，脱离死亡，以仁爱和慈悲为你的冠冕。第五节，他用美物使你所愿的得以知足，以致你如鹰返老还童。这一首诗，尤其在这个感恩节的时候，假使我们在念这首诗的时候，会有特别的感受。
And during this time of Thanksgiving, as we read these verses, we should have a special feeling.
那么大卫在写的这首诗，因为他上面写是大卫的诗，他说：“我的心啊，你们要称颂主。”
And so when David was writing this psalm, he said, "Bless the Lord, O my soul."
这个称颂还有一个意思解释叫做祝福。
And this bless is also praise.
那么神祝福些什么呢？
And what is the Lord blessing?
在这里面告诉我们说他的救赎。
That he is blessing his salvation.
神救赎我们，让我们成为神的儿女。
He blesses us with salvation so that we can be his children.
这个的救赎的角度的看法呢，对我们来讲，在感恩的上面来，这是一个很大很大的感恩。
And this perspective of salvation to us should be very great.
然后跟着下来，他说：“我的心啊，你不要忘记，你不要忘记他一切的恩惠。”
And then it says, "And forget not all his benefits."
其实来讲，我们在一年当中，我也看到我们在家家户户当中也有很多有碰到一些困难的问题的存在。
And in reality, throughout this past year, many of us may have encountered difficulties.
比如说我们的长辈生病了。
Perhaps our elders were sick.
或者是说我们在这个有些人被人家那个坏掉了。
Or perhaps some were laid off.
有些人呢，他碰到很多的事情不顺利。
Or perhaps some people kept on encountering negative situations.
但是大卫在这个地方写的这首诗说：“我的心啊，你要称颂主， 不可忘记他一切的恩惠。
But here David says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits."
有时候想想哦，我们要回头过来看的时候，原来啊，那个我们所受的苦呢，受的那些患难或者是那些事情，原来是一个被恩典把它包装起来的礼物啊。
And as we reflect upon what has happened, we see that those difficult situations are actually covered by the grace of God.
所以圣经里面教导我们说，凡事要谢恩。
And so the Bible tells us that we must give thanks in all circumstances.
所以我想说，今天从这个角度上，我希望在座的各位，有谁愿意要先来这里做见证的话，请你举手。
And so from this perspective, if anyone is willing to testify, please raise your hand.
那么我听说在徽州的教会，安息日聚完会以后，他们的信徒是排一列的在准备，他们要说见证。
And I heard in the African churches, after Sabbath services, everyone is lining up to testify.
有一次我在台湾的那个学生联会的时候，有一个传道说，我们这个也是见证会，人人有讲，每一个人都要讲。
And once I was in a spiritual convocation in Taiwan, and then the speaker was saying that everyone must speak.
后来我再仔细听下去，结果呢，那学生一个一个上来讲，讲得很快，说奉主耶稣的名做见证。
And then everyone lined up, and every student said in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I testify.
他说我感冒，我祷告了以后，主耶稣把我医治了，让我的热都退了，感谢主，阿门，就下来了。
And they said something like, I was sick, and thank God I prayed, and then He healed me. May all the glory be unto God's name. Amen.
结果那个传道呢，就要求一个一个的讲，他们小朋友就一个一个的讲。他说我祷告的时候，主耶稣听我的祷告，阿门，就下去了。
And so the pastor encouraged all the students to come, and every student came up to speak of God's grace.
好，那么有没有人要见证呢？
So is there anyone who wants to testify now?
那个好了，我点名好不好
？Can I will call on you.
今年结婚的人。
Whoever married this year.
今年谁结婚
？Who got married this year? Andy.
让你去体会这段圣经的意思。好 ，OK。
Let's bow our head and pray in silence.
我们一起同心默祷。
Amen. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I shared a few words.
奉主耶稣圣名分享几句话。
I wasn't ready to come up here. I thought I could, just not have this. I didn't have to testify, basically. So, but I'm here.
我没有准备见证，可是感谢神，我在这。
So yes, thank God this year was a good year.
感谢神，今年是一个很美好的一年。
There were obviously a lot of blessings for myself and my family.
神很祝福我跟我的家人。
And so in August, got married to a sister from Melbourne Church.
所以在八月的时候。我跟一个在墨尔本的姐妹结婚。
Thank God for guiding us through our marriage coordination.
感谢神带领我们的脚步。
And thank God that there have been so many people that have been praying for me.
我也很感谢很多人都一直替我祷告。
And also, thank God that.Just to continue to pray for our future.
很感谢神，请我们继续为我们的将来祷告。
During our interactions or our marriage coordination.
在我们的互动当中。
There were times when it was where I wasn't sure.
有时我不确定。
And it was like the fear of the unknown.
就像对未来不知道的恐惧。
And so a lot of it, actually all of it, 100% had to do with praying to God and asking him to guide me.
所以百分之百都是向神祷告，求他带领我。
And to face this fear of the unknown.
然后能够面对这些恐惧。
And to trust him completely.
然后完全的信任他。
Because it is like, well, it is like what it says in Hebrews 11 verse 1. It says that our faith is, maybe I should just read it. Faith is something you can't see.
因为像希伯来书十一章第一节所说的，信就是所望之事的实底，是未见之事的确据。
So in English, it's now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. And this has been a very important verse for me.
那这个经节对我来说是很重要的。
So I know I don't have a lot of time, so I just try to conclude.
所以我在我没有很多时间，所以我想要结束。
Just that I very much agree with the fact that when we go through difficult things, it's being covered by the great grace and blessings of God.
然后我也很相信，就算我们是遇到很困难的事情，都是由神的恩典所包装好的。
And everything happens for a reason, and God will bless those who love him.
然后每一件事会发生都有他的原因，然后神会祝福他所爱他的人。
So in the next few weeks, please pray for my wife's U.S. consulate interview. It'll be the 5th of December.
所以在即将来的这几个礼拜，请为我的太太要移民来要面试请替我们代祷。
And we'll continue to pray for each other in the Lord that all our families can become and strengthened in the Lord.
那我们也互相彼此代祷求神能够让我们每个人的家庭都能够坚固。
Because we know that in a family between husband and wife is like this relationship of Christ and the church.
因为在一个家庭，一个夫妻的关系就是像神跟教会的关系。
And this is what I'll share. And may all the power and the glory be unto His holy name.
我的见证到此，愿一切的荣耀颂赞都归于他的名。
还有没有人？有没有人要见证的？
Is there anyone else who would like to testify?
现在一点时间给大家想一想哈，我现在来讲的 Andy 的他们的婚事的事情。
I'll give you some time and then I will talk about Brother Andy's testimony.
我在回台湾的时候，有一天看到 Andy 带着他的太太，还有他的岳母，还有他太太的姐姐来到淡水教会。
And when I was in Taiwan, I saw Andy bring his wife and his mother-in-law and his wife's sister to Dansui Church.
因为他太太的家庭，我去墨尔本，我有去两次，所以他们家庭我们来讲，我们是认识的。
And so I know his wife's family because I've been to Melbourne 2 times.
然后呢，他们现在的问题就是说，我希望以后现在我们慢慢的有很多人到英国去，以后就在英国就找到了想要结婚的对象。
And so now I know many brothers and sisters go to the UK, and after going there, they find someone who they would like to marry.
但是呢，要注意的就是那个法令的问题。
But then one thing that they need to watch out for, be careful of, is the immigration matters.
对，好，所以呢，你要国际婚姻要结婚的时候，你那个美国的法令入境能够结完婚能够到。美国居住这些的动作要事先要准备要去做。
And so for an international marriage, you need to first think about the process of immigrating.
有很多人在问我说，哎，德恩，我的儿子德恩，哎，怎么不回来美国？
And so some people, someone asked me, why is it that my son is not coming back to America?
以前我们也没有想过有这个问题。
And originally, we did not think of this problem.
啊，结果呢，他替他太太申请来美国，美国政府居然拒绝他入境，不给他进来。
And so he applied for his wife to immigrate to the U.S., but then the U.S. Rejected her.
啊，他不能进来，只有他，他都过去了。
And so since she cannot come here, my son had to go over.
所以有人在笑说，德恩不是娶太太，是嫁出去了，嫁到澳洲去了。
And so some people said that Daniel was married off to Australia.
所以呢，我们凡事都。有一些事情神给我们去碰到这些事情的时候，我们要知道要预备准备做完了以后，然后这样子在国际的婚姻上才比较能够顺利一点。
And so when God allows us to encounter these things, we must first think through in order for us to have a smooth international marriages.
那么呢，还感谢主的呢，现在不像以前了。那以前要是这样结完婚，我知道他们蜜月旅行到了法国，蜜月旅行结束以后就分开了。
And
Andy 就回来这边，他就回到澳洲去了。
And I know that after the brother Andy and his wife's honeymoon, they went to France, and then Andy came back here, and then his wife went back to Australia.
其实这个一个新婚的人，这个分开坦白讲也是蛮辛苦的，蛮苦的了。
And so for newlyweds, this is very difficult.
但是感谢主啊，主耶稣替我们安排很好的东西，不要忘记啊。
But thank God, God has arranged something very beautiful for us. Let us not forget.
现在那个 FaceTime 啦，或者是 Line 啦，或者是什么东西，现在已经随时随地就在面对面在那里讲话了。
So God has given us FaceTime or Line so that we can video chat one another.
所以这个已经是。想到这个就要感谢神了，感谢神给我们这个有这么好的科技。今天虽然婚礼还是可以看得到，还可以是一起祷告。
So just thinking of this, we give thanks to God because even though they are not together physically, they can still video chat, talk to each other, and pray with one another.
哦，我记得我的儿子当时也是这个国际婚姻，他因为在澳洲。在家里面，所以每天到晚上十一点的时候，我的电脑都要让给他，让他用那个时候是用 Skype 那个 Skype 我就听他们在讲话，我就门关着，我知道声音，但是我不理他们，他们在那里沟通。
And so I remember, because my son Daniel's wife is from Australia, so at that time, whenever it reached 11 p.m., I would have to give my computer to him, and then they would talk to one another.
有一天呢，我跟我太太说，哎，奇怪，怎么两个他们在 Skype 当中呢？我听到我的儿子在那里祷告。
And then one day I said to my wife, oh, it's so strange, they're Skyping, but then I hear my son praying.
那个时候我们以为说，哎，他是不是两个在讲话讲得到在吵架？
And then we were thinking, oh, were they speaking with one another, and then did they get into a fight?
原来不是啊，原来他们利用 Skype 在一起祷告的。
But no, they were using Skype as a platform to pray together.
要是在我们那个年轻时代，这个是一件很奢侈的事情啊，也不知道付多少钱呢。
And in my time, this would have cost a lot of money to do.
所以呢，我希望 Andy 要感谢主，然后在太太还没有过来之前，都每天都要跟他 Skype。
And so,
或者是用 LINE 要好好的沟通。
Andy, I hope that you are able to talk to your wife every day.
这件事情是值得感谢的。
And this is a matter that we should give thanks
好
for.
好，还有没有人要见证
？So does anyone? Would anyone else like to testify?
好，没有的话，我们先来唱诗，唱一首诗再来。
Not let us sing one hymn and then.
我希望不要用点的啦，点的不好了。
And I do not want to call.
我来唱70首。
Let's sing hymn 70.
Sing.
因何起了我量，天这几多草满我心，并无别人是知，永远生命平安喜乐，都有耶稣赏赐。是我永相无依，天主基督的心，请我别人是知，永远生命平安喜乐，都有耶稣赏赐。以前我曾写多永远满足我心，今朝几多草满我心，因我别人是知，永远生命平安喜乐，都有耶稣赏赐。以前看重世间百物，未曾看重基督，唯独就这开我心目，是知足有王府，今朝基督充满我心，今无别人是知，喜乐都有耶稣赏赐。
我们现在请王永昌弟兄来做见证。
And now we ask Brother Alan Wing to share his testimony.
奉主耶稣圣名在这边做见证。
The name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I testify.
感谢神能够利用这一天的感恩节时间来做过去的一年的感恩。
Thank God that on this day of Thanksgiving, we can give thanks for this past year.
那我要见证的是有关于我父亲他就是在就是在过去年八月所发生的一件事情。
And I would like to testify about something that happened to my father last August.
因为有一天他打电话来跟我说这是他的就是他的排便当中他的大便是黑色的。
And so one day he called me and told me that His stool is black.
然后通常我们大概自己知道，大概应该是消化道的出血。
And so we know that it is because perhaps of bleeding.
然后我叫他去，可能要去医院做个检查。
And so I told him to go to the hospital for a checkup.
特别是一般大概都是胃出血比较多。
And often it is a cause of bleeding from the stomach.
所以当他这次检查回来的时候，医生是说需要再做一次的检查，因为发现里面有一颗异常的肿瘤。
So after his examination, the doctor said that he needs a follow up because the doctor found a tumor. Yeah.
然后一般就是做个切片就是切片之后发现它是不好的。
And they realized that it was a malignant tumor.
对，然后一般我们提到就是它的组织是不好的时候，就代表一般我们提到的就是恶性肿瘤。
And so, so knowing this, we thought it was a malignant tumor.
好，所以我们提到一般医生大概评估大概是第三期的肿瘤。
And so the doctor said that it was perhaps a tumor in its third phase.
所以医生是建议要手术，要先看就是进去看他的情形，然后再评估手术怎么做。
And so the doctor suggested that we should have a surgery to see what to do.
好，所以我们提到就是当整个报告下来的时候，医生评估大概是要整个做胃切除。
And so after the whole examination, the doctor suggested that his
just remove the stomach.
His stomach be removed.
好，然后我们提到就是其实整个以我们整个过去这样看来，其实第三期其实愈后就是他的状况其实都不是那么好啊。
And so we know that when it is this serious, there are not good things to follow.
那感谢神，我们都是信耶稣基督，我们都知道我们有依靠。
But thank God we all believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and we know that we have a reliance.
所以医生那时候在也感谢神，因为那时候教会有个姐妹过去在这个医院里面工作过。
And we thank God because there was a sister that had worked in this hospital before.
然后当时他们医院里面就是最厉害的医生就是肿瘤科的，就是他们的副院长。
And so the doctor who was the most skilled at that time, the sister knew.
好，所以我们可以其实在一般要看到好的医生在台湾基本上都是要排队的。
And so, in reality, in Taiwan, if you want to see a very skilled doctor, you have to wait in line.
因为这个医生本身就特别的忙碌。
Because these doctors are especially busy.
那感谢神，这个姐妹呢，就是能够借着她的关系，然后让我父亲用最快的时间进到手术房里头。
We thank God that the sister knew this very skilled doctor through her connection and was able to use the most.
所以从医生的评估来看，医生是尽量说能够保留一些的胃，不要全切除是最好。
To let my father go into surgery as soon as possible, and so the doctor said the best situation is to be able to keep a small part of the stomach.
但医生都会说，先打开的时候才能够评估到底能够保留多少。
But then the doctor always says that we must first open it up to see how much we can keep.
所以进去大概八个小时的手术之后，大概保留了三分之一的胃。
And so after 8 hours of surgery, he was able to keep 1/3 of his stomach.
好，你帮我们提到这医生也很忙碌，就是旁边也跟着许多的实习医生。
And this doctor is very busy. Often he has interns with him.
有时候出来，然后做个评估，再进去手术房，再继续做。
And he would come out and to explain to us, and then go back into the surgery room.
就是因为这样子，八个小时之后，然后就出来恢复室。
And because of this, after 8 hours, he was able to come out smoothly.
但是我们提到刚开始的时候还是要插管子。
But in the first, he still needed to be connected to some.
医生那时候的医生他是说最新的技术就是从管子插到肠子里头，不要经过胃里面去让它吸收营养。
And so the doctor said that the best way is for the tube to be connected to the intestine instead of the stomach.
然后就是用这个方式，但是有一个很大的副作用，就是非常的不舒服，会绞痛。
And so, but with this, there's a very great side effect, and that is that his leg was hurt.
所以在整个最辛苦的就是手术后的那一个月，那是非常痛苦。
And so the most difficult time was a month, the whole month after the surgery. That was the most painful time.
你只要灌那个营养品进到肠子里头，就会产生痉挛，然后就呕吐。
Because he would not feel well, and then he would vomit.
所以我父亲到最后都有点就是有点恐惧，只要要灌之前都会觉得很害怕。
And so my father began to be quite afraid and fearful.
但是后来到最后的时候，我妹在问我说，到底要不要？我是说如果。一般其实像我姐夫就是新云的先生也是肿瘤科的，他的意思说台北没有做这种方式，在就从肠子里面灌营养品的。
And so, my sister asked me what we should do, and I said that my brother-in-law, who is also a doctor for tumors, said that in Taipei they don't put tubes in the intestine.
北部的话，他们就直接进食，比较流质、比较好吸收的，一样从嘴巴进去。
In Taipei, what they do is that they just allow them to eat through the mouth.
当然，我是跟我妹讲说，其实也可以不用插管，让她直接吃。可是我妹妹是说尊重专业。
And so I told my sister that we can perhaps just let my father eat through his mouth, but my sister said that we should respect the profession.
所以一样就是经历那种痛苦的过程。
And so my father continued to go through this painful process.
感谢神，到最后的时候，情形越来越好的时候，就整个都拔掉，然后有嘴巴进食。
And thank God that as he recovered smoothly, he was able to finally eat from his mouth.
要接受大概15次的化疗。
And he had to go through 15 sessions of chemotherapy.
这是我们提到化疗也是很痛苦，也是有副作用。
We also know that chemotherapy is very painful, and there are also side effects.
其实我们能做的就是祷告，求神怜悯。
And so all that we can really do is to pray and ask God for His mercy.
其实感谢神，这父亲，我们知道，其实有时候我们做子女的，说真的也没办法做什么，但是就是借着祷告，然后每天就是用 LINE， 然后去跟他们就是聊天，讲讲话。
And as children, there's really not much we can do other than to pray for them and to talk to them every day through LINE.
其实有时候看到父亲那种很平和的那种，就是不会紧张、很平和的态度，其实做子女的也是很放心。
And so, as children, when we are able to see that our parents are just very peaceful to us, it's great comfort.
因为我们知道我们在主里面有盼望。
Because we know that in the Lord we have hope.
一切都是有神的旨意。
And everything has the will of God in it.
其实做最坏的打算，也就是只能接受啊。
And so even if we plan for the best, we can only accept it.
所以甚至我们提到我父亲做化疗，其实整个化疗之后，那种副作用产生出来的时候，非常身体非常不舒服啊。
And so after chemotherapy, there were a lot of side effects, and my father did not feel well.
甚至他没有做完整个化疗的过程。
And he was not able to finish the whole chemo process.
可以说他放弃化疗治，这是化学治疗。
And he gave up the chemotherapy.
所以他自己笑着说，医生还笑他说，你这个是就是逃兵啊。
And so the doctor said that he is running away.
就是你没有完全做好，然后你就跑掉了。
That he did not completely finish the process and ran away.
但是我们知道，其实一切都有神的安排啊。
But we know that everything has God's plan.
那时候我们提到，在病床，其实在旁边有很多一样的病症的病友。
And so in the hospital, there were many people who had the same condition as my father.
很多人一样状况，有些比他更好一点 的情形。
And some people were even in a slightly better condition than him.
但今年回去的时候，这些病友都不在了，都死了。
But this year when I went back, all of these people have all passed away.
那感谢神，父亲在神的保守之下，现在还很好。
And thank God, my father under God's protection is doing very well now.
食量跟正常人一样。
And he is eating as anyone else.
其实我们提到有信主跟没信主最大的保障，就是我们心里面有真正的平安。
And so the difference between Christians and non-believers is that in us we have a true peace.
有时候其实也是听他说，教会有很多姐妹也是因为这个情形，但是也是蒙主恩召啊。
And in church we also hear of the same situation, but they were called back by the Lord.
年纪也比我父亲还要年轻啊。
And they were younger than my father.
其实我们在信仰上面来到，其实神有都神的时候啊。
And so in faith, we know that God has His timing.
其实最重要就是，其实对于蒙主恩召的人，我们认为那是神已经息了他世上的劳苦，把他接回去了。
And to those who has been called back by the Lord, we believe that those who are called back have finished their work on this earth, and the Lord has.
因为通常有这种病症的医生都会跟他讲说，你台湾有健康保险。
Taking them back, and so in situations like these in Taiwan, the doctors will say that you have health insurance.
And 我父亲常在问他旁边人说，为什么你们打这个化疗不用钱，我的要自己付钱啊。
And so my father will often ask, why is it that when you go through chemo, you don't have to pay, but I have to pay?
医生哦，就是在旁边小声跟他讲，因为你的病症没有他们严重。
And the doctor will whisper to my father and tell him that it is because your condition is not as bad as them.
所以你需要自己掏腰包来做这个化疗，他们就是健康保险公司会付钱的。
So you have to take money out of your own pocket to pay, but they are insured by their health insurance.
甚至有些医生是说，现在有最好的药，一针十几万。
And so the doctors even say that a best shot is costs up to 100,000 NT.
这个整个疗程做下来一两百万跑不掉。
And so through this whole process, it may cost 1 to 2 million Taiwanese dollars.
但是医生都会跟这些病人讲，就是这没有保证一定会好的。
But then the doctors always tell these patients that there is no guarantee that they will be completely well.
最坏的情形就是人财两失啊。
And so the worst case scenario is that you lose your money and you lose your life.
但是我们提到，我们人总有一天会离开这个世上。
We know that all men will one day depart from this world.
只要我们提到说神，就是只要留我们的生命在，一定神有神的安排。
And if God continues to keep our lives, then there is His plan.
就是我其实常常在整个一个附近周遭的那些朋友有癌症的，其实有些人是怀着恐惧而走的。
And so those around me who had cancer often left this world with fear.
但是我们基督徒就是里面有盼望，我们没有恐惧。
But as Christians, we have hope and we have no fear.
因为启示录十四章十三节里面提到，就是其实在主里面死的人是有福气的。
Because in Revelation chapter 14 verse 13, it tells us that blessed are those who die in the Lord.
因为圣灵说他们息了他们的劳苦。
Because they have rested from their works on earth.
每个人都会息了在世上的劳苦。
And everyone will one day rest from their labors.
但重要的是有没有做工的果效随着我们。
What is most important is whether we have the fruit of our works that follow us.
所以其实在整个父亲在过去在去年八月整个发生的事情之后，其实在整个信仰一个非常大的体验就是我们人的路都是神在安排。
And so after what happened to my father starting last August, we all learned that God has his beautiful plan in everything.
我们健康不是我们自己很会保养啊。
And we are healthy not because we necessarily take great care of ourselves.
而是神的眷顾。
But it is because of God's keeping.
所以我们提到当我们身体有病痛的时候，我们要求神怜悯。
And so when we are encountering illnesses, we can ask God for His mercy.
我们身体健康的时候，我们要感恩感谢神。
But when we are healthy, we must remember to give thanks to God for our health.
那怎么感谢神呢？就是来，就是多做神的工啊。
And how do we give thanks? And that is to do more work for the Lord.
所以其实你是来让。来分享一下，就是在过去一年当中，真的是领受到神很多的恩典。
And so as we share, we realize that we have all experienced many grace of God this past year.
愿神就是将各种的福气来赐给大家，让明年大家有一个非常平安的一年。
And may God give everyone all kinds of blessings so that everyone may have a smooth and peaceful year.
那我们也继续用我们的口继续来称颂、感念神的恩典。
May we use our mouth to continue to praise and give thanks to the Lord.
因为一切荣耀归于天上的神。Amen.
May all glory be unto His holy name. Amen.
感谢神啊，我们刚才听到很美好的见证。
And thank God, we just listened to a very beautiful testimony.
我们刚才在念的诗篇的103篇里面的第三节，他说：“医治你一切的疾病。”
In Psalm 103, verse 3, we just read, who heals all your illnesses.
第四节说，他就赎你的命，脱离死亡。
And in verse 4, it says, who crowns you with loving kindness and tender mercies.
那个未开刀，未开刀，我记得我太太的祖父，季长老未开刀的时候，后来我有也带他来到二板这边，
And I remember my father-in-law also had a stomach surgery, and I brought him to Irvine once.
所以这个未开刀未切除多少哈，后来缝好了以后，其实他可以吃东西的哦。
And so after his surgery and after a part of his stomach was removed, he was still able to eat.
而且呢，胃越吃东西，胃会越胀，越胀会恢复到原状。
And the more he eats, his stomach will gradually grow again.
所以刚才在听他的见证的时候，听到永昌来讲他爸爸的那个见证的时候，让我们能够去体会到神医治我们，他到底用什么方式医治啊？当有神有神的方法，有神的有神的时间。
So as we listen to Brother Allen's testimony, we learn that God is able to heal, and He uses His own method.
好，我们再唱一首诗哈，跟下来 ，Tom 要换你见证了。
And after we sing him, we're going to ask Brother Tom to give testimony
爸爸的事情
to testify about his father.
我们来唱诗336首
Let's sing him 336.
耶稣是我，仍然看顾我，让我心中充满愁苦，肩头扛荆棘，重担难背负。这耶稣是我，仍然看顾，他别看顾。耶稣是我，仍然看顾我，有时黑云满天密布，我心间忧伤，我心内落苦，这耶稣是我仍看顾，阿别看顾。是我，人人看顾我，当我一时叹息难抵挡，我心间忧伤，痛苦难承担，黑夜里我泪水满眶，阿别看顾。使我有苦，摆着谁也痛苦黑夜，借机车灯救助避看顾。耶稣是我，仍然看顾我，当表表一永别不回。我心里破碎，有谁来安慰？忧伤心灵，谁来抚慰？阿弥看顾，阿弥看顾，因他提携我有苦，摆着谁？
我们请汤来这里做见证。
We ask Brother Tom to come up and give a testimony.
哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名做见证。
Holy in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, I testify.
做见证之前，我们请大家默祷一下，求神啊。
Before I testify, let's all bow our heads and pray in silence.
哈利路亚，阿门。
哈利路亚，阿门。
反正刘长老刚才叫我说要见证一下那个我爸的事情，那我没有准备想要讲我爸的事了，那我大概会讲一些啦，因为刚刚在下面的时候我在想说，如果说他选我的话，我要讲什么，我其实没有想要讲我爸的事了，因为我自己今年也发生很多事情，所以我大概也有讲一些我自己的事。
So Elder Liu asked me to share about my father, so I will share a little bit about my father and also about the many things that happened to me this past year.
那我先大概讲一下我爸是，因为大家比较关心，大家知道他那个时候他九月的时候就是九月底那时候中风。
And so first, at the end of September, my father had a stroke.
不过在那之前，他两个礼拜之前，他有先住院，因为他那时候牙齿那个，算是牙齿牙床那边有发炎。
And 2 weeks prior to that, he was at the hospital because he had an infection in his mouth, in his teeth.
所以那时候他因为他很痛，所以说我们带他去急诊，他就住院住两个，住了差不多一个多礼拜，因为他医院也发现说他那时候有胃出血，有 ulcer。
And because he had a lot of pain, we took him to the ER, and he stayed there for more than a week. And the doctor at that time also found that he had an ulcer, stomach ulcer. And so my father has diabetes and high blood pressure.
So he was in the hospital because of his infection.医生把他那个Tylenol把他停掉，因为他怕他出血出太多。
And because of his stomach ulcer, the doctor gave him Tylenol. Took his Tylenol off.
因为那个Tylenol他是可以帮他把那个血弄比较像 thinner， 就比较那个稀疏一点。所以他血会循环会比较好一点，因为他那时候在出血，他把它拿掉，因为他医生要他的血比较浓。
And so, when he had the stomach ulcer, the doctor told him to stop taking the Tylenol.
所以他出院以后，他那时候就是没有那个，反正就是，所以他出院以后差不多一个礼拜后，他突然一天早上，他就突然就倒在地上，那时候他就中风了。
And after he was discharged from the hospital, one day in the morning, he suddenly fell on the ground and he had a stroke.
因为他的就是他的一边的那个血管都全部完全堵塞。
Because on one side, his blood was clotted.
One side of our artery 全部。
One side of his artery was blocked.
Okay, 那时候就因为发生之后也是算很，刚好那时候我大嫂在那里，所以我们马上就是也是送急诊。
And when that happened, my sister-in-law was there, and so they immediately sent him to the ER.
那送急诊他也是有给他急救，不过就是。那个医生说，那个他堵塞的地方也没有办法打通。
And so, when they went to the hospital, the doctor said that they were not able to do anything
to clear the clot.
To clear the clot.
所以他其实对，所以他现在的情况就是变成是左边一边算是完全是瘫痪。
And so right now, his whole left side is paralyzed.
那所以他现在也无法站，也是没有办法自己站着，也行动都要一定要有人 就是24小时都有人照顾他。
So right now he cannot stand by himself and he needs someone to take care of him 24/7.
所以那时候也是没有办法带他回去，因为他一直说他回家，那我们也没有办法回去。那我们现在就是他现在就是住在了一个像是 born care home， 就是一个像是那种疗养院。
And so he really wants to go home, but he right now is at a boarding care place because there's someone taking care of him there.
Yeah, 所以他现在请所以他现在请我讲，那我感谢主说我们他那个我找那疗养是就是离我们家很近，所以我们每天都可以去看他。
And we thank God that the place he is staying at is very close to us so that we can go see him every day.
那照顾他的，因为他那个是比较小的疗养院，他现在最多差不多就六个病人在那里，有两个人在照顾他。
And at that place, there are only six patients and there's two people taking care of him.
要照顾的这几个人也都还蛮善良，还都还蛮不错的。那也都把他算照顾的不，都不错这样。
And all those who are taking care of him are very kind and taking a very good care of him.
因为之前在他进疗养之前，他是住院跟住那种复健中心，都比较大的复健中心，那边护士人比较少，就说就照顾就比较会忽略到。
And so prior to this place, he was at a bigger hospital, and so it was harder for people to take good care of him.
对，因为他因为人手都不够，我现在他的情况算是稳定了。
Because there was lack of manpower, but thank God, right now he is stable.
所以所以九月那时候他就是入院了两次。
And so at the end of September, he was hospitalized twice.
所以所以这几个月来感谢每个弟兄姐妹帮我们家人祷告。
And these past few months, we really thank everyone for interceding for our family.
Okay, 那我见证我自己一些事情，因为这个跟我家人跟我们也有点关系。
And so now I will testify about some things that happened to me.
我感谢主。那我今年七月那个我七月初的时候我被 lay off， 我被那个算是解雇。
And so in July I was laid off.
那在那之前，怎么讲？我在那几个礼拜，刚好那一两个礼拜的时候，我们家人在考虑要搬去那个北加州。
And a week or two prior to that, our family was considering whether to move to Northern California.
所以那个时候，因为在考虑说要搬家，我们那时候其实有点有心情，就是有点犹豫不决，也不知道怎么样做这个决定。
And so at that time, we did not know how to make this decision.
所以说那个时候大概就是我们那时候就大概想一下说，哦，那我们就是搬去北加，然后大概小孩子跟那个跟我太太先上去，那我工作那在那像我把这些在南加州的房子整理好，然后我那边找到工作，我再上去。所以我会先在南加州一阵子，这样子，至少几个月内这样。
So at that time, we decided that my wife will bring the children up first, and then I will stay in Southern California as I look for a job, and then move up afterwards.
I 在北加找到工作，那时候我再上去。
And then I would move up once I found a job in Northern California.
所以我不算那个时候，算是那时候我爸生病之前，我们觉得哦，这事情很多，所以那时候心情很不好。
And so before my father became ill, many things happened, and I was not. feeling well.
Yeah. 然后就不很感谢主，嗯，就是，就是当我被 lay out 那一天，就是我们认识应该是七月五号，我记得就是 Fourth of July weekend 嘛，就那时候，因为那时候 Fourth of July 那个 long weekend， 我那个长假也没有，那时候因为心情很乱，也没有过得很高兴。
And I really thank God. The day I got laid off, July 5th, and prior to that, the long weekend, I did not really celebrate because I was not feeling very well. I was very, I had mixed feelings.
所以我那天被 lay off 那天，我其实突然，好像一个重担掉了这样子。
And so the day that I was laid off, I felt like a burden was taken off of me.
因为我老板跟我讲说你被 lay off 的时候，我不是觉得恐惧，我突然觉得，哦，所以我知道我的决定要怎么走，我的路要怎么走了。
And so, the day my boss told me that I was laid off, I understood the path that I should go on.
Yeah, 那时候就是觉得好像 OK， 我就是准备，我就是要搬去北加这样子。我那时候本来一直犹豫不决。
And so at that time, I knew that our family was to move to Northern California because prior to that, I wasn't sure how to make the decision.
所以那时候我就跟我太太讲，然后我太太也，我们就是觉得整个也算心里很平安，说哦，我就是这样子做，我不会觉得说哦，那我 以后工作怎么办？
And so that time I told my wife, and we both were very peaceful and were not afraid of the future.
Okay. 那当然，从那个比较实际的生活讲，我也想哦，那过了几天以后，我想哦，那我也赶快，我也至少最近也先找个工作，那就算他是暂时的，我也在附近先找一下，或是在北加找一下。
And so after a few days, I thought I will look for a job here and in Northern California, even if it was only temporary.
Okay. 那我之前，因为我被要这个工作，我差不多做了差不多三年。
And so this job that I was laid off at, I had worked there for around three years.
他工作性质，就是他一定要我做 算是比较长的时间，那我都要做差不多四个小时或超过四个小时，所以我每天做的其实蛮累的。
And so for that job, I would often have to work more than 40 hours, and so I was very tired.
因为他就是一定要你在花那么多时间在那里。
Because the company required that you spend so much time there.
虽然说我的工作不需要做到四十个小时，我其实四小时内我就可以做完。
So in reality, my job does not take more than 40 hours per week.
那所以我之前已经就一直讲到想要换工作了。
And so prior, I already wanted to find another job.
Okay, 所以我被解雇的时候，我没有很伤心的。
And so when I was laid off, I was not very sad.
那我在我公司的时候，我有一个同事，就是跟我做了差不多一年，然后他就走了。
And so in my company, I had a coworker who was there for 1 year and left.
然后他走的时候是他回到他的旧公司去。
And when he left, he returned to his old company.
他那个旧公司的老板，就是那个 owner 那种老板，他是我认识二十几年的，的一个也是一个算是同事。
And the owner at the old company, is someone I knew for 20 years.
那时候我想说，那我既然认识他们两个，我去先去那个至少暂时去那里跟他找工作，至少可以跟他做个几个月，等我事情办完了，我人就走这样子。
And so I thought, since I knew both of them, then I can go there temporarily until I finish my work here.
Okay. 那我想说，我之前那个就是这个公司这个老板， 因为我认识他二十几年，我知道他其实他这个人不太好相处。
And so the owner of that company, I've known him for 20 years, and I know he's not very easy to interact with.
那所以我那时候我之前就是有一种感觉，说我以后都不跟他一起工作了。
And so I had thought that I would never want to work with him again.
那我就是跟我工作一年的同事，他当他走的时候，他跟我讲说啊，不，他这个，他说我这个老板他已经这二十几年了，他整个人的性质都改变，他现在人算还蛮好相处的这样子。
And so before my coworker had left, he told me that the boss of this company has changed his personality and he's much easier to interact with now.
所以我那想说啊，那好了，那我就去至少去试试看。
And so then I thought, okay, at least I'll try.
那我去就跟他就去 interview 这样子，然后他也说，他那时候就说啊，他们刚好在找人，所以他要我什么时候开始都可以。
And so then he told me that they're also looking to hire someone, and I could start anytime I wanted to.
然后我很比较惊讶是说，他是跟我讲说，那他说你，而且他说现在他工作性质就是我其实都不需要进去公司，我人可以在家里做。
And so he said, for the nature of the work, he said I don't have to go into the office, I can work from home.
所以那时候我想说。我那时候想了这样做，说想，那我人如果在北加，我也是蛮方便的这样。
And then I thought, then even if I am in Northern California, then this will be very convenient.
Okay, 所以那时候我大概就是，其实那时候应该是八月，那时候就开始工作在那个，也是在南加这边就是开始工作这样子。
And so I started working first in Southern California.
所以当九月我爸那个生病出事的时候，还有我就是不需要人在公司，我也可以去有时间花，然后照顾我父亲。
And so when my father was ill in September, I did not have to go to the office. I could still take care of him.
那因为现在去看医生的时候，也都是要我们现在都要自己带他去，那我也要去帮忙，要去搬，算是把他搬起来这样子，从轮椅搬上车下车，所以刚好因为我不用在人在公司里面上班，我都可以去带我父亲去那个去看医生。
So to take him to the hospital, we would have to drive him ourselves, and so I would be able to help since I did not have to physically go into the office, and I was able to help carry him to go to see the doctor.
所以我们家人跟我自己虽然说发生这么多事情，好像就是其实看起来是很不顺利的一个过程这样。
And so it may seem that many unsmooth things happened to my family.
就像我啊，我被解雇好像是一个很不好的事情。不过其实，现在觉得说他，我没有被解雇的话，我大概也不会去找新的工作。
And so it seems like being laid off is a negative thing. But if I was not laid off, I would not go look for another job.
那我在那公司其实做也不高兴，所以我大概也是心情也是很不好。
And I was not happy at the company. Anyway.
那我也没有时间，真的。如果说我爸需要帮忙的话，我也没有办法去照顾他。
And I would not have had time to take care of my father.
那所以感谢主，就是大概神也知道，神知道我们的脚步，说我爸要他生病，他需要照顾他，他先准备好我换工作这样。
And so truly God knows what will happen, and so he had prepared this other job for me already.
那很感谢主，我们我前几个礼拜去看医生，那医生就是看脑科医生，我带我爸去看脑科医生。
And so I took my father to see a neurologist.
那当然我爸现在就是一像是中风一半瘫痪，那一半没办法动。
And so my one half of my father's body cannot move.
那不过那个医生说，不过他还算，他跟我讲说他还算蛮 lucky 的。
But the doctor told me that he is considered lucky.
那我在想说，为什么他算幸运呢
？And I thought, why is he considered lucky?
他说，因为他中风的那一边，他是中风，他影响他脑部那一边，他影响脑部那边是他没有办法动。
And so, the side that was affected from the stroke is that he can't move.
不过他说。对，不过他没有影响到说他讲话，跟他吃饭，他就是他的 speech， 然后他人也是，神志很清楚，他也都记得之前的事情，他也都有办法跟你沟通。
But it has not affected his speech, and he can still eat, and he's still very conscious and can communicate with you.
所以他说他刚讲说他的生活品质算还可以，因为你还是可以，你还是可以。他还是知道说他父亲发生什么事情。
And so his lifestyle is still okay because he knows, what has happened recently.
所以感谢主，我听到这样，我就比较安慰一点，说，他情况有可能更糟糕。
And thank God, after hearing this, I felt, comforted because I knew that the situation could have been much worse.
那我就见证到此那。求神继续带领我们家人。
So my testimony concludes here. May God continue to guide our family.
愿神的荣耀都愿全全部荣耀都归归于主耶稣。
May all glory be unto the Lord Jesus.
Ah, 感谢主啊！我们刚才听到他们的见证。
Thank God, we just heard Brother Tom's testimony.
今天我本来想说找被人家 delve 的，结果没有想到他也碰到这个事情。
And so I did not know that he also encountered this situation.
但是我们可以发现，就是说，凡事都有神的美意了。
But we see that in all things there is the beautiful will of God.
虽然我们看到所遭遇的事情，有时候我们感觉到是想不通，为什么遭遇到这种事情。
And so sometimes when we encounter difficult situations, we may think, why me?
但是呢，我们回过头来看这件事情的时候，你就可以发现到，其实呢，我们碰到每一件事情，都有神的美意存在。
But as we reflect back, we see that in everything there is the beautiful will of God.
汤的爸爸，我有去看他三次。
And so I have visited Tom's father 3 times.
我来美国。进到这个加护病房，只有一次。
And so after coming to America, I've only been to the ICU once.
就是刚好 Tom 的爸爸送到加护病房里面的时候。
And that is when Tom's father went to the.
但是呢，我一进去就被护士把我赶出去。
But when I right when I went in, the nurse told me to go out.
那时候我看他躺在那边。
And at that time, I saw his father laying there.
第二次去看他的时候呢，我是看他被推在太阳底下在晒太阳。
And the second time I went to see him, he was on a wheelchair to get some sun.
因为他状况的关系，所以脸的那个有歪一点啊，那个肉肌肉这个地方那个有点问题。
And because he had
歪掉脸歪掉了。
His face was crooked.
但是呢，我也看到是说最配合的。病人最配合的病人，我所看到的是黄汤的爸爸。
And but then I also saw that, the most willing to cooperate patient, is Tom's father.
那昨天我再去第三次去看看汤的爸爸。
And yesterday for the third time I went to see Tom's father.
我就发现他让我感到意外的就是说，他既然讲话。很清楚。
And what shocked me the most is that he speaks very clearly.
那个头脑思想很清楚。
And his head is very clear.
这个是真的是说起来真的是很感谢神的啦。
And truly, this is something we should give great thanks to God for.
所以我们在今天这个感恩节的特别的聚会的时候，要结束前，我再读一段圣经就来结束。
And so before we conclude this Thanksgiving special service,
我们来看罗马书的第八章。
Let's turn to Romans 8.
请看二十八节。
Look at verse 28.
罗马书第八章二十八节。
Romans chapter 8, verse 28.
我们晓得万事都互相效力，叫爱神的人得益处，就是按他旨意。被召的人
Verse 28, and we know that all things work together for good to those who love God, to those who are the called according to his purpose.
好，那么在这里面告诉我们说，万事都互相效力。
And here it tells us that all things work together for good.
那么呢，在这里面说，叫爱神的人得到益处。
For good to those who love God.
就是按着他的旨意被召的人。
To those who are the called according to his purpose.
感谢主，我们今天早上的感恩节的特别聚会就到此要来结束。
And thank God we conclude our Thanksgiving.
我们一起来唱诗四百九十一首。
Let's sing hymn 491.
Let
us pray together, and in our prayer, let us give thanks.
虽然我们每一个人所遭遇到的问题都不一样。
Let us offer our thanks, even though every situation that we encounter is different.
但是呢，可以让我们体会得到神的恩典、神的眷顾、神的带领，却是有他特别给我们的恩惠。
But through all this, we understand that. He has a special grace in all things.
所以我们在祷告的时候献上我们的感谢。
So in our prayer, let us offer our thanksgiving.
等一下我们祷告结束以后要谢饭的时候，请我们的主席哈，John John来这里做谢饭。
And so after our prayer, we'll ask our chairman, Brother John, to give us grace. Let's pray in one accord.